Thank you for coming to view our TimeQplus demo. My name is Debbie, and first of all, I'd like to show you a couple things that are not associated with the software itself, but would be of interest to you, additional helpful information. First of all, the upper left, you have File. When you click on File, you will see that you do have preferences as to your password. You can change your password. Also, a lot of people do like 0 to 23 hours. Now, this system does come AM, PM only for 12 hours, but you can have 100s, decimal hundreds, or minutes. For that, you just go to User Preference right here, and you can simply change it from minutes to hundreds. Also under File, you will see Systems Utilities. That's another area. If you do decide that you do need an increase in your employee capacity, you simply come to your Systems Utilities. After you call AcroPrint, you will receive a different install code to go with your password, your serial number. Simply come into Systems Utilities, down to Upgrade, click on Upgrade, and enter your new install code. Click OK, and your increase of capacity is all set. View right here is just another section of your navigation bar, which does go up along the left side of your screen. We also have documentation in four different languages. We have English, Spanish, French, and Dutch. If you just simply click on English, you will at that time view all of the user's instructions and quick start sheets to help you with your software setup and any questions on your system. And last of all, the help screen. If you do need to call into AcroPrint for any information or tech support, come down to About TimeQplus. You will be asked for your software serial number in your version, and that is found under this About TimeQplus screen, version 4.1.41, and your serial number is located in the middle. Now we're going to go on to the TimeQplus itself. This is your home screen, and as you see, you do have a help button at all times here, or a need assistance down here. First of all, we're going to click on Employees. For demo purposes, I do have it set up with several employees and also an employee who is discontinued. First of all, if you do want to add a new employee, you simply click up here and you would type in the last name, first name, middle initial if you do need so. If you're using a hardware time clock with badges and you do have badge numbers, that would be a 10-digit configuration and you would list that here. Your user ID is necessary. That would be for clocking in and out on the PC itself, or if you're using the keypad on the clock with a PIN entry. Your number here is associated usually with your payroll package, perhaps a separate employee number. And we list over here either your shift or your department. You can name your shifts anything you'd like, whether you'd have them named department or area, location, and of course your hire date over here. Your hire date is necessary in order to populate any holidays that are paid, and we'll show that further on in the demo. I'd like to show you here also down at the bottom you will see detail. In the details screen you are able to assign your employees their password if you are punching in and out on a PC, and also associate the work codes with your employee. Your work codes are also associated in here, where you can assign your employees the work codes, whether they're authorized to clock in at that location or work code or not. We also have here one, an employee that is crossed out. Now they no longer work here, and what happens is that does stay recorded like this with the line through the employee for two pay periods. At that point, you can edit the two pay periods, the current one and the previous one. After two pay periods, this employee will just drop out of the system. However, their archived information will remain. Next, we're going on to messages. This is a section where you can choose all companies, all company employees, or just individual employees, and send a message to them. This is for PC Punch only. It does not show up on the display of any of the hardware. Next, we have setup. In the setup, you would initially have your general setup. We have chosen a biweekly pay period for this particular demo, and it will show you the next start date on that. You can also choose to approve any timesheets in this section. We have a section here where you can list your holidays that would be paid for, and also on the right-hand side, the probationary period before the employees are eligible for a paid holiday. Last on this particular screen are the work codes. You can list them, you can have them the PC, the software default to choose a code for you, or you may enter your own code for each individual work code. You can name them whatever you would like. Now this can also be work codes, locations, departments, and a brief description of that particular work code. Next we have shifts. In this system, we do have 12 individual shifts, including an extra one for salaried employees. The salaried employees, as you can see here, is just going to be a default for 80 hours for the biweekly pay period. And their holidays, they are paid holidays, and they're paid 8 hours per day per holiday. Also on here, you can see that we do have a total of 12 additional shifts. Again, you can name them whatever you would like, and each individual shift does have different clock rules. The office area, I do have the shift rules enabled, and my shift start time is 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., and I've chosen rounding, a 15-minute round and docking feature. The maximum time on the clock, meaning after 12 hours, the system will realize that you have missed a punch, and the next punch in would be an in punch. The day change offset 00 is midnight, meaning that is the day that this system, this particular shift, will change from one day to another. Continue down with the production shift right here, and as you can see, I have not enable the shift rules, meaning the employee would clock in and clock out, and the time would calculate between those two punches. We have on here the warehouse also. Now, as you can see, I do have shift rules enabled here, 14 hours maximum time on the clock. Now, their hours are different. Their rounding rules may be different per shift. Also, each shift can have their own lunch rules. This particular one is not enabled, therefore the employee would clock in and clock out, and the time would be deducted as to the time in between those punches. You can have the shift rules enabled for lunches, and that would mean that there would be a parameter of hours. In between those hours, you would have a duration, whether it's 30 minutes or 60 minutes, and it would automatically deduct after so many hours of the original punch in and the beginning of work. Your overtime can be calculated different for each of the 12 shifts. This particular shift, I have it set up on a daily overtime after 8 hours and double time after 12 hours. You can have each individual shift either with daily or weekly or whichever applies to that particular shift or department. Also, holidays. The holidays are paid in this particular shift, and the employees do receive 8 hours per holiday. Next, we're going on to punch editing. This is where you can add any employees' missed punches. You can see here that we do have in punches and out punches. Along the left-hand side, you will see PC and INS. Now, these items are the way that the data was communicated into the system. The PC means that the employee actually punched on the PC. Insert means it was inserted by an administrator. You also may see CLK for a clock, or USB for a USB thumb drive where you had your data uploaded to your software from your clock. In this particular area, you can see a transfer of job codes. This particular punch here went from job code 5 to job code 2 at 7 p.m. and then clocked out at 9 p.m. We also have an insert of sick time on here and also a missing punch. Now on the missing punch, you can, as the administrator, come down to here and you see that it was a missing out punch for the 29th. You can simply come down here, pick the 29th, pick the time for the out punch, and insert it. It always does ask you to verify, and simply click on yes, and your missing punch is filled in. Also on the screen, if you have an employee that is called in for a vacation, you can populate that one pay period in advance. Under the type of punches that you can have, there is a variety. There is a punch or regular. There's vacation, sick, holiday, other, and FMLA. You can edit time totals on this screen and also approve timesheets. Over here on the right-hand side, you will see the different categories and the different time calculations and what categories that they do fall in for the pay period. These will also show up on the employee's timesheet or time card. Now we're going to move on to reports, and I will show you some of the more popular ones. We do have them grouped in four different settings. The global settings are ones that are throughout the whole system. The holidays for the system, the rules that are set up, and the different 12 shifts that you do have. Those are global settings for the whole system. We have employees, and that gives you their employee profile, their supervisors, and who's in, who's out report. Now the who's in, who's out report is excellent to see. You can sort by employees and preview and actually see who is on the clock and who has not clocked in for the day. This is used in case of emergency. You can quickly pull your time clocks, go into your who's in, who's out report, just to make sure that you have all the employees that you need out of the building at a certain time. Next, we have the time reports. There are several of those. As you can see, approaching overtime, average totals by employee, totals by day. I am going to show you, first of all, is your average totals by employee. Now, this particular report here is the only one in the system that is able to be sorted by date range. This report is for information that is necessary for your Affordable Care Act reporting. It is a minimum of a 30-day stretch, and all employees are included on it. It will give you the number of hours worked, the number of days worked. This information, again, is necessary for your ACA reporting. Another one on here is hours summary. And again, I am going to go by all employees. You can see here that the date range is grayed out, but you are able to sort by pay period or pay period range. A pay period range is if you would like to have from one pay period to another, not one date to another. So I am just going to go here from 7/27 pay period up till the current, and I'm going to pick all employees and preview. It will give you a range of all the regular hours, your overtime, your sick, your vacation, holiday, and the employees' numbers and their default shifts. Last on this particular section is the time card itself. This current pay period, I'm going to take an individual employee and Victoria Adkins preview. On this, you can see that you do have your insert for punch here. You have your hours worked. You do have a breakdown of the hours and the days and the dates, and also a summary of the hours listed down below. It is able to be signed by the manager and employee for your records. Last in the reports are your work codes. If you do have work codes or departments or location transfers, as I showed you earlier, you can sort them, the totals by work code by employee or work code by work code. And with the work code by work code, what that does is it gives the employees that did work under those codes and for how many hours. Next, very quickly, we're going to export. This is the pay period that you can choose. You can sort and export by all employees or individual or by individual shift. We have many different formats that you can be used for exporting, including a generic ASCII file, which will export all of your data into an Excel spreadsheet. Now we're under Supervisors. With the Supervisors area, you always do have an administration for every system. As you can see here, I have it checked as the administrator. Down here, it is grayed out where it says Assign Unassigned Employees. The administrator has the rights of the system to view and edit all employees and anybody on the system itself. I also have John Jones set up as a supervisor. And when I click on him, you can see that this is highlighted. Simply click on that and you can tell who is assigned to John Jones. These would be the only people that would be able to be edited, viewed, reports run on. He would not even be able to view these employees over here. Now, if you wanted to, you can toggle back and forth and move the employees accordingly, depending on which supervisor they move to, or you can just leave them unassigned. Last here, we do have the time clock section. This is where you would have your IP information and any kind of communications, whether it's Ethernet or USB. We also have the USB thumb drive or flash drive. You would be able to add your clocks here or remove a clock here, and you have all of your communications details for the clocks. If you would like, you can simply poll and update a clock individually or multiple time clock updates. And you can assign or unassign employees per clock.